Ranjan Tiwari. Today I am going to teach you class 9th Beehive, second unit, The Sound of Music. This extract written by Deborah Cowley. This is a very important extract for you. In this extract, you find some important terms. First, you see the terms. It is a biographical piece. This biographical piece tells us the people who have achieved success and recognition through determination, hard work, and courage. In this extract, you find three important tools for success: determination, hard work, and courage. And I want to ask children who read this extract to think of potential barrier to success and of people who have overcome them. When you go through the extract, here you find the tools of success. If any barrier come in your path and how you overcome from that barrier. The second point is also very important in this extract. God may have taken her hearing, but He has given her back something extraordinary. God may have taken her hearing power. She was deaf, but God has given her back something extraordinary. This thing is also very important for us. Sometimes we blame on God, but when we think about the blessing of God, about the bless of God, then we find how God make us, how God presented us, gifted us extraordinary power. And the third point is also very important. What we hear, she feels far more deeply than any of us. A person who has hearing power, but she develops her hearing power from senses. And that extraordinary power is better than her hearing power, better than the hearing power of the others. So she said, she feels far more deeply than any of us. That is why she expresses music so beautifully, and she was able to express music so beautifully. And the last important point of this extract is a person who fought against a physical disability. A person who fought against a physical disability and made her life a success story. A person who fought against that disability, then he made him better than the others. These all things you find in this extract. This extract is very important for you. If you think about the success of that girl, then you find, and then you find how she struggled against her disability. In this extract, we also know about the power of determination, hard work, and courage. These three things, these three tools are a ladder of success. In this extract, I want to read out the extract, then I explain these lines. Rush hour, cowards jostle for position on the underground train platform. A slight girl, looking younger than her 17 years, was nervous yet excited as she felt the vibration of the approaching train. It was her first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London, and daunting enough for any teenager fresh from a Scottish farm. But this aspiring musician faced a bigger challenge than most. She was profoundly deep. In the first extract, the poet describes about the first meeting of that girl who made her success. Once writer was on platform, and there he found a 17-year girl. That girl is slight, looking younger than her original age. She was very nervous, but she was excited, and she felt the vibration of the approaching train. And she was going to participate at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London. And it is very difficult for the teenagers to participate that Royal Academy in first time. And that place, poet writer meet that young girl. Evelyn Glennie's loss of hearing had been gradual. Her mother remembers nothing, something was wrong when the 8-year-old Evelyn was waiting to play the piano. They called her name and she did not move. I suddenly realized she had heard say Isabel Glennie for quite a while. Evelyn managed to conceal her growing deafness from friends and teachers. But by the time she was 11, her marks and deteriorated, and her headmistress urged her parents to take her to a specialist. It was then discovered that her hearing was severely impaired as a result of gradual nerve damage. They were advised that she should be fitted with hearing aid and sent to a school for the deaf. In the second stanza, writer describes about the first notice of her disabilities. Once her mother called her, but she was not noticed her calling, and the first time she felt about her loss of hearing power. Gradually, she loses her hearing power and her school teacher or the head mistress also felt her losing hearing power and teachers suggested her parents to provide him her hearing aid or to admit it in a deaf school. In the second stanza, we see these things. Today I want to stop my teaching, and next class I continue my lecture. Thanks.